Hi guys, I'm Tom Bruce, Head of Delivery at Snap Analytics, a UK-based analytics consultancy and also a Snowflake partner. This is the second in our Snowflake series. In the first, we showed how you can scale up servers instantly within Snowflake for increased performance. And today I'll be going through zero-copy cloning within Snowflake. So, zero-copy cloning within Snowflake allows you to instantly copy tables or even entire systems instantly without actually replicating the data again. So, you're only storing the data once. So, to be able to clone data within Snowflake, you can use the clone command. So, we have a transactional data set here which has 61 million records. So what we'll do is we'll clone this table to create ourselves a test table. And you'll see that this is now running that clone operation here and it's instantly created. So that was just 3.5 seconds. And now we've got our test table. So you can use this if you've got specific scenarios where you want to take production tables, you want to apply some changes, test those changes. And then you can also use the clone operation to promote those changes back into production. So we'll imagine the fact that we have a particular change which has been requested to add the trip size column. So Citibike want to find out from their trips which ones are classed as short, medium, and long. So I'll run the alter statement on our new copied table to add this new trip size. So anything which is 10 minutes or less will be a short trip. Anything which is between 10 and 20 minutes will be classed as a medium trip, and then anything else would be categorized as a long trip. So this will be updating our test table. We can see that we've updated the 61.5 million records there. So we've obviously cloned our original data from the transactional table. So if we look at the existing table that we had, we can see that our operation on the cloned table hasn't updated it. So this still has just the original columns. We don't have our trip size column in here. However, if I now select just 10 records from our new test version, we should see that we now have our trip size column available. And this is then categorized those trips into medium, trips into long, and also into short trips. So we've tested this. We can see that our trip size column is working as we'd expect. So what we'll now do is we'll promote that change into the original production table, again using the clone command. So we'll create and replace our normal Citibike's transactional data trips table. And you can see that within a second, we've now updated that. And if we actually look at the original table that we had, this Citibike TD trips, we should now see that we have our trip size column correctly put into our production version. As you've been able to see, zero copy cloning allows you to instantly copy data for testing purposes, also for production cutover. And the amazing thing about it is it only stores the data once, so helping you to actually save on both loading times but also save on storage cost. I hope you found this video useful. Stay tuned for the other videos in our Snowflake series. Thanks a lot. Bye bye.